Hello once again to another exciting edition of Shaw Sports. I'm Curtis Anderson back at Bedford Road today talking to Carolyn Parr-Hillestad. Now, Carolyn, I came here this afternoon looking for the cheerleaders. I did not find them. I found you and your POM squad. What is a POM squad?
Our POM squad is a synchronized dance team. We don't do any stunts or tumbling or gymnastics elements. We're strictly a combination of jazz, hip-hop style, the POM elements of cheerleading, so the sharpness of arms and synchronicity of, like I call them, my synchronized swim team on the dance floor. They want to look like one unit dancing together, showing off various dance elements.
Now, of course, we were trying to preview B.R.I.T. That's why I was here trying to talk to the cheerleaders, but it turns out you guys are going to be performing at B.R.I.T. as well.
We will. We perform Thursday night for the opening day of competition at a halftime performance. Then we entertain the homeschool crowd at the pep rally Friday morning. And then our big performance will come Saturday as part of the cheerleading competition. And we are a demo event this year, along with Walter Murray's dance team. Their POM squad is also coming. So we're excited that POM is gaining some popularity in the city and we're not the only one anymore.
Give me a little history of POM. I've never heard about this before. Okay, Walter Murray has one. Props to Walter Murray, my former school. Bedford Road has one. How popular is it?
Well, we're finding that it's gaining popularity in that we don't need the mats and in order to practice. We don't have as many safety regulations. The girls just have to have proper dance shoes. And basically, we practice in hallways, in the lunch area, in the commons, or in the auditorium here when there's space. So we can practice anywhere. So because of that, I think it's gaining popularity. We've traveled to competitions in Regina, where POM is huge. Almost every high school there has a POM squad, and in competitions that we've been to in Alberta, going to Edmonton, it's also very big there. I think it's starting to gain popularity here as well, so we're excited about that because it's not as much fun when you're the only one.
All right, I was here 1 year ago talking to the former cheerleader coach, Amber Maffin, and she was saying how people get so desensitized to cheerleading. You know, you throw someone up 5 feet, the crowd wants you to throw her 10 feet. You know, things get more complex and as a result get a lot more dangerous. Is that kind of an appeal of POM now? People are starting to get away from cheerleading. This is a little safer?
I think there is, there's definitely less danger involved in it. And I think some of the girls here are dancers outside of school and enjoy dance as their favorite pastime and just enjoy that they can come and be part of a school team, that they're not, you know, joining the soccer team. Or, well, actually, I have soccer players, hockey players, and basketball players on the team as well. So there's a variety of skills and interests.
I was watching you guys practice before we started this interview. Looks like you have to be in pretty good shape to do this too.
Oh, for sure. The girls go through some core strength workout, like Pilates type training, and flexibility all the time. And they're always, they're using their minds all the time to be sharp and together. So
all right.
Yeah, I think they're pretty good athletes.
Yeah, it looks like a lot of fun, Carolyn. If some young women out there want to take in the sport of POM, why should they? What's the catch?
I think for our girls, it's all about the dance. They love to come out and represent their school, and they love the travel to out-of-town competitions. That's a big draw. Going to Edmonton last year was a huge highlight of our season, where we won the Ross Shepherd Cheer Championships in the POM division, being grand champions. So that was pretty exciting. So popularity is building around the school. I had almost double the amount of girls out for tryouts this year than we did last year. So I think the popularity of being able to dance, staying in shape, being with a group of girls that are just fantastic to work with, and they build lasting friendships, and they just have a great time. So it's a lot of fun.
All right, you mentioned at the beginning of the interview, maybe let's finish with how can they come check you out at B.R.I.T.? What time? Where?
The cheerleading showcase begins at noon on Saturday, and come early to get good seats because it is always just packed to the exit doors and some overflow, and we'll be there performing as a demo event.
All right, thanks so much for talking to us today.
Thanks a lot.
And good luck.
Thank you.